Good evening, I'm Craig Cannon. Angela is off tonight. There have been a series of rooftop burglaries in the River Valley. 4029's Monica Limper joins us now in the Fort Smith newsroom with more on how these thieves have been making their entrance. Monica?
Craig, it's an unusual way to enter. These thieves have been cutting holes into roofs of buildings and using ladders to climb in and steal.
How are you guys doing today?
Good. Carl Howerton takes pride in his Golf USA store in Fort Smith, but he felt violated when a burglar snuck in after hours.
Well, the entry point was up here in the ceiling, right up here. And they cut a hole in the roof, came down through the ceiling. That's the hole he cut into the roof to come down.
Last week, a burglar came into Howerton's store through this small hole in the roof.
It's a very small hole. Somebody that is very thin came down. Fell through the ceiling.
Of all the expensive golf products the thief could have taken, Howerton says the thief took only a small amount of cash.
They could have took a whole lot more in product than just a little bit of cash they got. Leads me to believe that they're not interested in golf stuff. They need money for whatever addiction they got.
Police say in the past month there have been over a dozen burglaries like Golf USA's in Van Buren and Fort Smith, leading them to believe the same person is committing these break-ins. Even though none of Golf USA's products were taken, the burglar managed to take away the one thing Howerton was saving for a good cause.
We had a big water jug full of a bunch of change and some bills that we're saving for First Tee as a donation. And we've been getting a lot of customers putting money in it and stuff. And they also took that, and there ain't no telling how much money was in that.
And First Tee is a program that supports kids playing golf. Police are still investigating all of the burglaries, and so far there's been no word on any suspects. Craig, back to you.
Okay, Monica, since Golf USA's break-in, a suspect damaged the lock of the roof access door of Toys R Us in Fort Smith, but couldn't.